Hi all, welcome to Vision Board community. So today we have a guest, Krishna Priya, and she has almost 14 years of experience. She recently cracked 2 offers in Azure Data Engineering side. So I'm inviting to Krishna Priya to just share her experience, how she cracked, what are the challenges in the 14 years of experience people are facing, how she resolved, how to get these offers added. Krishna Priya, are you there?
Yeah, hi Devi.
Hi, Krishna Priya. Krishna Priya, welcome to this community podcast. Actually, I just want to know about how are you able to crack in 14 years? You already have a 14 plus years of experience. What is the main challenges you can able to facing when you attend an interview? Okay, because experience is high.
Yeah, first of all, thank you for welcoming me for discussion. Yes, my journey is I have total 14 plus years of experience working with Infosys. And my journey to Azure data engineer role comes in I had worked on previous SQL migration projects. It was just SQL Server. I had worked on SQL writings, stored procedures and views and etc. So I had an interest on SQL side mainly, though I had worked on multiple .NET projects before. But the technology was keeping on changing throughout my journey. So finally, I thought I should divert it into one. And that is how I got into a project, an ETL project. And that was in SSIS. And then the client had changed into Azure Cloud. That was migration from on-premise to Azure. And that is how I thought of, I will concentrate on this Azure data engineering role. Some of my friends also had taken this, started with DP900, DP203. I got a few advices from them, and I started myself taking all the certifications first so that I get an idea.
How is the interview process actually? In 14 years, how is an interview process?
So interview process, it's like the same, for every, as an interviewer, we will explain our project, what are the different projects which we have worked on. But relevant to when we are applying for Azure data engineer role, the relevance would be more for Azure data engineering, right? So whatever I worked on, so I had worked on a cloud data migration project, so I explained that. Currently I am in a data engineering project, so I just explain these many months only I am into this project. So I just I don't tell that I have worked extensively on it, or so this is my current experience, this is how what I have done here. I am willing to learn, I am always motivated to learn, and that is how I even though I means I have SQL 7 plus years of experience, so if I will say that I have more knowledge on SQL stuff
And any kind of architecture kind of thing or anything any designing round you face while attending an interview? Any kind of designing kind of rounds you face in the interviews?
No, I do not face such a design phase and all. But yes, they will ask about common questions like dimensional modeling. Such questions would be there, that everyone knows, right? Stars, snowflakes, schema, etc. Such common questions, I think that
they'll be asked, right?
Yeah.
And one more thing, one more question, most of the people are asking me, how difficult it is switching 10 plus years of experience?
Yes, I too had all these like scared of interviews because I've been these many years and how can I attend and what would be the questions? They'll be expecting a lot from us. So, but as we see this data engineering role, I have been only with the like 3 years of 3 years experience, right? So they won't ask very big questions also, not like in architect level because I that is our experience, right? So based on our experience and based on whatever we tell about ourselves, the questions would be based on that.
No.
I don't think experience is a problem here.
Experience is not a problem. If you at least you have learned something, definitely interviews also cooperate with us, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And finally, do you want to kind of any kind of motivation or any kind of suggestion you want to give to the people who are preparing to interviews, like an actual data engineer?
So yeah, as I say, like yeah, I get motivated from people like you, like Devi, who is on posting in that is like when we move nowadays. I think LinkedIn is a very good source of motivation where we can see all types of questions and what to learn, what is the journey, and such. There are so many. Like in YouTube also we have. So we have all the materials available, just that we need to give some time, take some time out of our busy schedule and try to improve ourselves. That's the only thing. Yeah.
I think, Krishnapriya, you are like an inspiration journey. Thanks for your inspiration journey because most of the people are scared to jumping actually. So when people are talking to me, maybe how can I jump like, after 10 years or 12 years, I can show your video, right? That's why I am asking these kind of questions like a podcast. Thanks, Krishnapriya. Anything else you want to add in the community or like in helping to people?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. That's all we will.
Okay. Thanks, Krishnapriya. Thanks for your time. I think Krishnapriya's journey will be inspiring to everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.